Being able to write and scribble with paint expands the ways it can be used. While some is packaged with a tip that doubles as a writer, most aren't. Enter these empty liners, which allow you to transform almost any paint or medium into a writer, doodler, or dot maker. In today's video, I'll show you how to write and make marks of all kinds using them. About the only limiting factor as to what paint or medium you can use with the liners is the viscosity. If it's thick, we can work around that. Assuming it's a water-based paint, we can thin it with water. But something that is so thin that once it's in this tube, you take this cap off and you hold it like this and it just flows out the tip, well, that's not going to work, and there's really not too much that we can do to remedy it. So when you talk about paint, some of them will need to be thinned, and again, I'm going to assume we're working with water-based products, which means I'm going to thin it with water. So this is the Pebeo Studio Acrylic. It says high viscosity right at the top there. High viscosity means it's a thick paint. When I first put this in here, it was definitely too thick to work well with. Too thick from a couple of perspectives. First, that it took a lot of hand strength to really squeeze this and get the paint to flow out. And secondly, I wasn't getting really good. This was dots. This was way too thick, and I wasn't getting really good dots. I couldn't get them to dome. So you have a couple of options. You can put some paint out in a container, mix a little bit of water in it, and then put it in the tube, or you can simply go ahead and put some in the tube, put some water in it, and then get it mixed in until you're satisfied with the viscosity. The thing to remember is that even the best packaged paint, whether you're talking about a high-quality paint like this, or you're talking about a bottle like the Finnabair acrylics, which I've used, the Finnabair Art Alchemy paints, which I've used extensively, it's unfortunate, but paint does get thick when it sits in the jar or when it sits in the tube. Again, all you got to do is thin it with a little bit of water till it's at a comfortable viscosity. So the other thing to bear in mind is that how thick or thin the paint is going to affect the appearance of what happens when you squeeze it out, whether you do a line or you do dots. So when you look at this group of lines, this is a dilutions paint. This is my same Pebeo Studio Acrylic. This is one of Tim's Distress paints, that speckled egg. And this right here is gel medium. Happens to be Dina's gel medium, and we'll talk about that in a second. But you can see there's dimension on all of these. If I hold this way, you can see that there's some height to those lines, and certainly there is height to these dots. Now, the thing to notice here is you can see that these dots are not nicely domed. Well, the reason that they're not is because the paint is thick and you have to coax it into a dome shape. Now, I could have changed what went on here too, again with the flicking that I'll show you in a second. So you just need to remember that there are ways to kind of get it to perform or to behave the way that you want. So when you want to put lines on a page, for example, it's actually very straightforward. All you have to do is pop your cap off, put this down, and draw your line. Very straightforward. Now, dots, of course, are another kettle of fish, and I'll come to that in a second. Actually, before we go any further, I want to show you how to get paint in tubes. So when you are talking about something like gel medium, and yes, I know Dina's gel medium is available in those 1-ounce squeezy bottles. I use them all the time. This happens to be the gel medium I reached for and found first, so let's assume it's a different brand for the sake of argument that's not available in those 1-ounce squeezy bottles. It's really easy to get this in here. I like to tap so that the product is not all gathered up here in the neck of the tube. You need to be able to have a place to kind of feed it down into. And then I'm just going to use a palette knife. I'm only not going to put very much in, but you just put a palette knife in like this, and you can kind of feed the product in. It's not a big deal. Only takes a moment. And again, you just tamp it down until you've got as much in there as you want. So let me wipe these threads before I put that cap back on. So when you get these liners, you're going to get them in two pieces. And let me show you what I mean. So they come in two pieces like this. You have the tube, and then you have the cap and tip assembly. These caps don't screw on and off, they just snap on and off. Once you get this product in here, you put this on. So let's grab one of the Art Alchemy colors. This one is French Lavender. Very straightforward. All I'm going to do is pour this in. Now, if I have paint in a tube, it's even easier. All I have to do is position the little lip of the tube inside the neck of the thing here. The neck of the tube, oops, and I'm good to go. All right, so let's wipe this off. plenty of paint in there to do what I want to do. I believe that the capacity on these is 25 ml. All I'm going to do is screw this on. All right, so now that we have paint and a liner, let's talk about something fun to do with it. And dots are probably about the easiest thing that you can think of. And dots are, there's about what you'd expect. You're going to put the nozzle down. Let's use this because it's here. All you're going to do is put it down and squeeze. Now, something that's reasonably thin is going to pretty much dome on its own. You don't have to do a heck of a lot with it to get it to do it. But something else, conversely, like the Pebeo, and let's just grab, well, this is just a piece of printer paper. It's not very thick, but I'll fold it in half. So when you work with something that's a thicker viscosity, and I now have paint on my hand, you have to kind of coax it into a dome shape. Whether I was doing this with a studio acrylic, or even if I wanted to make dots of gel medium. So when I put this down, I'm going to exaggerate this. You can see that I would get that giant Hershey Kiss thing going. But what I can do is coax it into more of a dome shape by flicking the bottom. And you can see now that that is definitely much more of a dome shape. And I can continue to flick that, which will actually cause it to almost flatten on the top rather than be kind of mounded like that. So dots are one of my favorite things to work with. This is a page that I printed on a gel press plate using one of Elizabeth St. Hilaire's stencils, and off the top of my head, with apologies to Elizabeth, I don't remember the name of this one. But it's a very effective and very easy technique to get pattern and color down on a page, on a card, on a canvas, on anything that you want to do. This is about as easy as it gets. Super simple to do, and very, very effective. And you can make your dots as big or as small as that, as big or as small as you want. Making marks with these liners is pretty easy, and your repertoire can expand to all kinds of things, straight or curvy borders, doodles of all kinds. You can scribble flowers and circles. The thing that I discovered in all of this playing was that for me, trying to go slowly was not good. I did not get good results. I got wobbly lines and things that just didn't look good. I find if I move my hand reasonably quickly and decisively, I get much better results. As you practice, you'll figure out what works the best for you. So for example, a little curvy border like this that's been embellished with some dots looks great. A straight border that is kind of straight. I mean, it's not meant to be curvy like this, but it is straight-ish. You can get really interesting effects with all of those kinds of things. I'm knocking stuff down over here. So let's try a straight border to begin with. So if I come in here, all I'm going to do is trace the basic outline of this tag. Oops, almost got the cover in there. That wouldn't have been good. Once this dries, or even beforehand, if I want to come in and add some dots, I can do that. The one thing that I didn't say, I generally try to shake this down to get the product down in the tip. I do it. I obviously didn't remember to tell it to you, but I just did. All right, so now let's talk about curvy borders. I'm going to work with this purple, I guess. Or you know what? Let's work with this turquoise. So curvy borders, I just kind of do them freehand. I will say I practice before I'm doing this, and I've been practicing as I've gone along. So don't think that what you see me do, I just picked this up and hadn't done anything. It all comes with practice and with familiarity. So for me, I like curvy, swoopy lines like this. That's it. I can leave this alone. I can come back. I can doodle. I can add dots. I mean, all of these things in combination, as I said, they all start to make really interesting things. And I think that adding dots is a real effective way to kind of gussy that up and make it look really good. Now, the other thing that you can do is you can create kind of sketchy circles. So let's see what will contrast here. Let's, I guess, use this. So for me, fast is definitely better. If I want to come in and embellish these a little bit, something that is fun, let's grab this pink. I can put some spokes on here. And you can't see them super well, but they're on there, and I know that they're there. All of the things that you do that kind of make these things these pieces, these pages, whatever they are, they just make them look a little bit more interesting. So you can see the pink spokes there. If I wanted to come back and I wanted to add a little bit more, I could put a dot on the end of each of the spokes. Really, whatever you want to do, experiment, as I said, whatever you try that you think will work. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't, but more often than not, they do. So writing with paint is obviously one of the best reasons to do all of this, to take the time to put this stuff into these liners. Before I forget, 25 mil, I think I forgot to say that before, but nevertheless, that I believe is what the capacity of this. So writing, it's something that you can do very easily with this, and now you have this, whatever range of paint you have is pretty much what you can do. So for example, you can print. You can write cursively. Oops, help if we dot that. That might have been a little bigger than it needed to be. So, as I say, this is just cheap old printer paper. Practice on things like that. Get your hands comfortable with the flow and the motion that you need. And before you know it, you're going to have a range of liners in all kinds of colors that you can do all kinds of fun things with.